Hello, friends of human spaceflight, and welcome to another week in review as we look into the space industry and notable launch activities from around the world. Coming up, Israel overtakes Russia as the third-ranked space superpower. We bid farewell to Ariane 5 and lots more space news, so let's do this. It was a bittersweet moment for fans of Ariane 5 this week as it took to the skies for its farewell flight. Originally scheduled for the 4th of July, severe weather delayed the final mission for Europe's only heavy lifter. After nearly 30 years of service, the mighty Ariane 5 soared over French Guiana on Wednesday, the 5th of July, transporting military communication satellites for both France and Germany into geostationary orbit. One of our other TSMG correspondents, Tom June, streamed the launch live on his channel too. We'll leave a link to the launch stream in the description below. The farewell launch comes 27 years after its debut on the 4th of June 1996, supporting a multitude of crucial scientific missions, perhaps most notably the recent James Webb Space Telescope in 2021. Ariane 5 established a history of reliability for Europe, boasting an impressive 82 launch success streak which lasted between April 2003 and December 2017. The heavy lift vehicle has been Europe's steadfast ride into orbit. Despite this, talks surrounding the value of these launches as we move into the future led to the creation of the Ariane 6 booster. Ariane 6 has all the charm of its predecessor, but will be much more cost-effective for its customers. Although facing numerous timeframe setbacks, Arianespace continues to work towards completion of its final testing phase before a debut launch date for Ariane 6 can be announced. Before we say hello to its replacement, let's take a moment to appreciate some of Ariane 5's greatest moments. It's farewell for Ariane 5 and thank you for your service from us here at To The Future. We will of course bring you the latest developments on Ariane 6 and Europe's next ride into space as things progress. Huge news this week as ESA's highly anticipated Euclid mission launched from Cape Canaveral, Florida on Saturday the 1st of July. This was the first self-funded SpaceX mission for the European Space Agency.
Following successful launch and separation, signal acquisition was confirmed from Euclid by Australia's New Norcia ground station.
Nestled within the confines of SpaceX's mighty Falcon 9 fairing, Euclid's innovative 1.2-meter space telescope and its optical and near-infrared scientific instruments were designed to shed some light on the structure and progression of the mysteries of the dark universe. Euclid will record images of billions of galaxies in stunning clarity with its 600 megapixel camera to a distance of 10 billion light years and establish the largest, most detailed and informative 3D map of the universe that we have ever seen. The mission aims to finally put to rest the age-old question, what is the universe made of? Euclid will travel for about 30 days before reaching its insertion point, followed by 2 months of powering up, instrument calibration, testing, and preparation for its incredible task ahead. Euclid's final destination is the Sun-Earth L2 Lagrange point, which is the point at which the Sun and Earth gravitational systems are equal and gravitational pull ceases. This final resting place is approximately 1.5 million kilometers from Earth and is ideal for surveying the sky without interference from Earth or the Moon. The space telescope will establish its extraordinary 3D map of the universe over a period of 6 years. We should expect to see the first images returned within the next few months. As if that's not exciting enough, the data retrieved by Euclid will enable the Euclid Consortium, a dedicated team of more than 2,000 scientists from 300 institutions across Europe, the US, Canada, and Japan, to test how Einstein's theory of general relativity differs in the cosmos. They hope to better understand the attributes of dark energy and identify if the force in the universe is constant or dynamic, and eventually how this relates to the fate of the universe as we know it. Keep your eyes on To the Future as we unveil all the latest updates from this exciting mission. It has been 3 years since the Artemis Accords were established by the United States to bolster support between countries in achieving their common goal of space exploration. Signatories have committed themselves to taking reasonable steps to support each other in the exploration of the Moon and Mars. On June 21st, another of the world's leading countries in space exploration dedicated themselves to this purpose, strengthening the multinational pact. In a huge step forward for the country, India has signed the Artemis Accords. This is crucial for several reasons. According to some experts, India's space program has surpassed Russian capabilities, and notably on a shoestring budget compared to the USA. They are actively testing and preparing to send humans to space, with reasonable ambitions of creating their own Indian space station. While some feared India might follow in China's moon-crazed footsteps and refuse to sign the Artemis Accords, their dedication to them has secured India's alliance with NASA and may soon open the door to Indian astronauts on board the International Space Station. All this at a time when Indian interest in space is at its peak, given the upcoming Chandrayaan 3 mission to the Moon set to launch in just a few days' time. The Artemis Accords, for anyone who isn't already aware, is an extension of the Outer Space Treaty of 1967, which was initially launched on 13th of October 2020. The Accords are designed to support humankind's efforts in space exploration, and countries that have signed the Accords are in agreement that space exploration is a government and civil effort of peace. Although the Accords are lengthy, there are some crucial highlights you should be aware of. Signatory countries are committed to the following.
The principles of the Accords are simple, intuitive, and universal. Transparency, rendering emergency assistance to astronauts in distress. Respecting heritage sites. The public release of scientific data for all to enjoy.
Thanks, Jim. The Artemis Accords provide great insight into how countries are supporting each other in their space exploration efforts. We will drop a link below for anyone who wants to read them in full. Next up, let's hear what Angry has to say about the Astra Carta. Over to you, buddy.
Hello and welcome to my latest segment here on To the Future. In the grand tapestry of human history, we have always sought to push the boundaries of our knowledge, to unravel the mysteries that lie beyond our grasp. Our insatiable curiosity and relentless proof of discovery have led us to the threshold of the next frontier. Within the last decades of space exploration, we have seen extraordinary technological advances with benefits that reach beyond the domain of space. As humanity stands on the precipice of this new era of space exploration and development, it is of utmost importance that we approach this endeavor with a profound sense of responsibility and care. A powerful opening to the new governing document for humanity's pursuit of exploration and development of space. But what does the Astra Carta really mean for the future?
And why am I so angry about it?
The Sustainable Markets Initiative launched the Astra Carta in London on the 28th of June, presenting a new framework to drive the private spaceflight sector to drive for the development of responsible and sustainable space exploration for years to come. The document further develops the guidelines set forth by its preceding document, the Terra Carta, which was established in 2021. While its parent document revolves around the importance of promoting transformative action in the area of nature, people, and our home planet, the Astra Carta builds upon our ambitions and sets out a strategy to merge the common vision of private space organizations with governments, international organizations, and other stakeholders while accelerating our advancement beyond Earth. The vision for the Astrocarta was first expressed by the newly crowned King Charles III in 2022 at the Space Sustainability Summit and was created with input from leading space experts from around the world, including Colonel Chris Hadfield, former Canadian astronaut and commander of the International Space Station. Industry leaders were invited to a reception at Buckingham Palace last week for the reveal of the official Astrocarta seal and to show their commitment to the sustainability framework. All of this sounds like a giant leap in the right direction for humanity's endless quest for advancement in space. But why we even need this document really pisses me off. It all boils down to three words. Humans are slobs. Gone are the days of inherently doing what's right for the environment over our own selfish needs, and why shouldn't the same apply to life outside our planet? Space exploration has become lax, messy. So much so, in fact, that industry leaders apparently now need to shake hands and swear an oath to a king to clean up their act before their debris brings a catastrophic end to civilization. We are literally floating in a starry sea of our own man-made crap in space, hoping for the best as we try to avoid one disastrous collision after the next. We continue to build mega constellations without servicing or deorbiting the hundreds of redundant satellites that we already have littering the atmosphere. We allow small space companies off the hook for the debris they create because they don't have the resources to clean up their own mess. There are over 1 million pieces of space debris circling us as we speak, and we turn a blind eye when space companies turn to countries with relaxed regulations. Well, guess what? The doomsday clock is about to toll for these companies. Astrocarta's emphasis on responsible sustainability is essential for ensuring we are holding companies to account for their actions. It is vital for our future advancement and humanity's mission to expand beyond our home planet. I just hope the framework hasn't been put in place too late. There is a link in the description to the Astrocarta if you'd like to see exactly what it outlines. Back to you, Sam.
Thanks for that, Angry. Great to have you on as always. Well, that's all for this week's Journey Through Space. Thanks for joining us. We will be back next week with a fresh selection of hand-picked news as we bring you the latest developments throughout the industry and some fun along the way. Thanks for watching, and as always, onwards to the future. Signal acquisition was confirmed from Euclid by Australia's New Norcia Ground.
God!
Signal acquisition was confirmed from Euclid by Australia's New Norcia. Signal acquisition was confirmed from Euclid by Australia's New Norcia Ground Station.
God!
Norcia!
Norcia!
Do that.
Following successful launch and separation, signal acquisition was confirmed from Euclid by Australia's New Norcia Ground Station.